Hey everybody, thanks for tuning in. This is the new Whiteboard Series from the Virtual Strategist. My name is Erica Olson. I'm the CEO of On Strategy. We're so glad you're here. This is one of four parts in building a responsible AI policy for your organization. And I know the word policy just makes us all a little bit not want to do it, but this is easy, it's important, and of course, we have a simple whiteboard for you to make it as fast and as effective as possible. So just quick ground setting. There was an overview of a responsible AI policy video. Check that out. There was another video on AI guiding principles. There is also an AI video on communication and learning. This one is on building a governance structure. If you want to use the actual whiteboard instead of just this video, click on the link on the screen. Let's jump in. Okay, so an important part of AI and AI governance is being clear about the structure you're going to use to govern the implementation of responsible AI. And responsible AI is implemented through guiding principles and through teams adhering to those guiding principles. In addition to that, it's implemented through learning, evolution, new tools, failing, succeeding, all of those things. And so making sure that you're clear about what your oversight structure is going to be to ensure that you're managing the implementation of AI in a smart and responsible way, that's what governance structures are all about. So three parts to this exercise. Let's jump in and check it out. The first is to just determine your current state and your future state of a governance approach. So we've got your a little scale over here, a little set of criteria. You can sort of see that over on the side. So the way it works is that you plot the white star on the various characteristics here, or scales, if you will, about where you are today, and then you plot the darker star on where you'd like to be. And this is specifically in relation to AI initiatives and management. So it's possible that your current state is non-existent. So I want you to just not worry about that. There might not be a current state, but the idea is to be clear about where you want to be in your future state. What is acceptable to you? So for example, human involvement in decisions. It's the first one, a little small right there. Where on the scale do you and your team want to be in terms of human involvement in decisions related to AI and AI initiatives? Out of the loop, meaning independent, or in the loop, we want to be included. Where do you want to be with that? Privacy and data practices, open sourcing or highly restrictive. Most people are probably going to be over, in the highly restrictive area. So that's that one. Design approach, cross-functional or SME leads, etc. So you can kind of see how this will really help you align on where do you and your team fall on this spectrum of tight or loose, if you will, in org structure, flat or hierarchical, etc. And based on that, so you have dark stars plotted all the way across this, right? And based on that, that's going to give you a understanding for part two, which is choose your type of governance. So there are three types of governance structures. You can use more than one, actually. So just kind of note that. So if your stars are skewing to the left on your chart, you likely should deploy a decentralized governance structure. So you see that here skewing to the left. If you're skewing to the right, you're likely going to deploy or likely should consider deploying a centralized governance structure. And if you're somewhere in between, you're probably going to want to deploy a center of excellence, meaning, multi dimensions that pull together cross functions across the entire organization. And again, you might end up doing a couple of these. I would keep it simple, of course, but the entire purpose of the scales and then, of course, to pick one of these three is to be really super clear and agree together. How do we want to govern AI? So hopefully that's helpful, because sometimes we jump into this conversation and it's a little all over the place, and our intention is to give you really nice, almost like a little survey, collective survey to take in order to tell you what you might consider or maybe you should be leaning towards based on your comfort with these various attributes. Okay, so then once you have that figured out, then you need to move over to step three, which is actually outlining it and, quite frankly, filling in some names. So you will select one of the three, so that's what you'll do here. And then based on that, you're going to want to establish names associated with this AI committee. That AI committee would be decentralized. In a decentralized capacity, it would be a single owner. In a centralized capacity, it would be the AI committee. And in the center of excellence, these would be participants plus others. So obviously, you should have an executive champion, probably an oversight lead. Again, that oversight lead, if it is decentralized, would be a bunch of different people. If it's centralized, it would be one. A technical lead, same thing. A legal lead, that's something that was just to consider, super important. And then, of course, other members, depending upon who might need to be in the conversation and what, you know, what model you're picking. But again, you can kind of see that if it's centralized, you're probably just going to have one name in most of these boxes. If it's decentralized, you'll have multiple boxes. And then if it's a center of excellence, you're going to want to round it out even more with cross-functional ownership. So with that, hopefully we've helped you really take some of the mystique out of what a governance structure is and help you really simply and quickly land what your governance structure could be and should be to help you manage, govern, shepherd, and implement AI in your organization. Thank you so much for tuning in. Check out the rest of our videos on responsible AI, of course, to cover the rest of the bases to develop your responsible AI policy. And subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We're dropping videos on this topic and many others all the time. You want to get notified for sure. Happy strategizing.